So thank you so much for coming, for joining us today. I am Maria Perifanou, for those who were not connected before, but you just joined us. I am an Italian language teacher and technology enhanced learning expert, project manager and a senior researcher at the Smart and Mobile Interactive Lab of the University of Macedonia in Thessaloniki. I will talk to you today about the work that we have done in the context of the DC4LT project regarding DC4LT framework and tool. So in the beginning, I will define a little bit, explain a little bit what digital literacy is and competence. Then I will continue with the research methodology adapted. Then I will present the DC4LT assessment framework and tool, and I will conclude with the main results. So basically, in the age of digitalization, there is a growing need for teachers to acquire new sets of skills and competencies in order to face the new digital challenges that they encounter in their work and their daily life. In fact, according to the European Digital Agenda, digital literacy is one of its 7 pillars, while the Council of Europe defines digital competence as one of the 8 key competencies for lifelong learning needed in the 21st century, and its development should be perceived within the idea of lifelong learning. The OECD report of 2009 also expressed the big need not only to integrate ICT into schools' curricula, but also to invest in training teachers to use them for teaching and help students learn. Digital competence is a highly important competence for all the teachers, and especially for language teacher, for all of us, because teaching online, the languages online, is different from teaching other subjects online because it entails different skills, such as the creation of highly interactive language environments that could address the language practice needs for language learners. So how do we define digital competence and digital skills? Is this the only term used to describe the skills needed for using digital technology? As you see, the concept of digital literacy or competence is a multifaceted moving target, as it is still interpreted in various ways in policy documents, academic literature and teaching, learning and certification practices, educational reports. So we often we hear like, digital literacy skills, technology skills, technology literacy, 21st century skills, ICT practitioner skills. So let's see how it is defined. So here I have some definitions. Newman, for example, proposes looking at digital literacy as the use of critical thinking skills in the context of technology use. According to this, reading digital literacy can be understood as requiring both technical and critical thinking skills. In this diagram that we see, critical thinking skills are seen as an attribute of information literacy. In the review, Newman clarifies that the focus is more on thinking rather on technical skills. And in fact, in the review, information literacy sometimes used as a synonym for digital literacy. Here, I continue with Alamutka, and in this diagram, it is shown that internet literacy, ICT literacy, and media literacy, and information literacy are partially overlapping with what we call here digital literacy. All the above mentioned literacies contain a digital component, and in return, digital literacy is enriched by the new means and tools derived from technological surge and convergence. So what here we have from Ferrari, that is very well known, she defined digital competence as a set of knowledge, skills, and attitudes that are required when using ICT and digital media to perform tasks. So you can see here different tasks such as communication, manage information, create and share content. As Professor Mikro said before, you know, we need to know all this basic, also to have all these technological skills and to have the basic knowledge. So it's, let's say, a mix of things that we need to know. The majority of frameworks generally that we have explored are based on skills development and on the ability to use a specific set of tools and applications. So skills are only part of the learning domains that are included in digital competence. And the ability to use specific tools or applications is just one of the several competence areas that need to be developed by users in order to function in a digital environment. But what we have done here in the context of, in the framework of the DC4LT Erasmus project, we wanted to explore which are the digital skills that language teachers need to acquire and how could these teachers self-assess their digital competence. So here are the basic research aims: define the digitally competent language teacher, design a framework and a tool that will describe the digital competencies, and then design also a training model that we have done and in order to deliver our training sessions. So here is the research methodology. As you see, four steps. The first part, the needs analysis survey, it is just presented by my colleagues. And then we continue with the literature review. And the literature review, based on the findings of the literature review and the needs analysis survey, we designed the assessment framework and tool. Based on all this, we have organized and designed the training model and session. So this is how we did. Okay, so I will go to the first phase. As we saw the results of the first phase, we have a gap in language teachers' continuing professional development, lack of language teachers' confidence, many, as you see here, lack of technical infrastructure and a growing need for language teachers' training on the use of emerging technologies and innovative pedagogies. Here, this is what we saw before, and from the literature review is in line, in fact, with what we found in our survey. So we just confirmed what we already knew. The systematic review, literature review on digital competence frameworks and tools has shown that there is a variety of digital framework for educators proposed by official organizations and researchers. And here I'm just passing that to go here, that we have, let's say, a variety, as I said, of digital assessment framework and tools, but we have only a few that are dedicated specifically to language teachers' digital competence assessment. And yes, there is, let's say, a specialization here. We need to have a specialized, let's say, training on that. And also, we have many digital competence assessment tools that are based on digital competence assessment framework. So, in fact, what we have first, it is the framework, it is the theoretical background. And based on that, we create the tool. Some examples here, as you see, it is the digital competence of educator, the DigiCobe tool. And based on that, it is we have the self-assessment instrument. We have the this one. It was based on the DigiCompeDo framework. And also we have, for example, another tool, the Microsoft Certified Educator Digital Assessment Tool, which is based on the UNESCO ICT Competence Framework for Educators. So those are interconnected. Usually when we have a tool, usually it is connected to, it is based on another, on a specific framework. Now, I will show you here some digital framework for teachers that are very well known. They're not for language teachers, but they are very well known. And here is the DigiCompeDo that I said before for educators by Joint Research Center. We have the UNESCO, two versions of that. And another one is this framework from the Norwegian Center for ICT and in Norway. So those are some examples. And here we have some examples for digital framework for language teachers. For example, this one of Cambridge is really excellent because it has a framework, so theory, but it has also a tool that it is online and you can assess your digital skills. And also it has also a variety of tools as the one that Ursula Stickler described before. It is another platform with tools, but less rich in comparing to the ECML's platform. Another one is this one, the TESOL Technology Standards Framework, that is also nice. And the EQUALS framework for language teachers training and development, that it is not only focused to digital skills, but it gives a full perspective of the skills that a language teacher should have. In this book, there is a chapter, it focuses on digital skills. So also the results, we got results from our project and from our research. It was about the assessment tools. As I said before, the frameworks and the tools are interconnected. So they were different and varied. They had varied characteristics. There were some of them, they had several types, like they were oral tests, printable tests, online assessment tests. They had various formats, other were free or paid. They offer a type of accreditation or not. And usually the providers were all well-known organizations, or they were outputs of projects like ours. And a tool that it is also well-known and it is under development is the selfie for teachers. So that it is provided from European Union. So it is also a nice one. So I go to the third phase, that it is the DC4LT framework tool. What we have done, our framework was inspired by previous research which was conducted in the area, such as the framework for online language teaching skills by Compton, the EQUALS framework, the Common European Framework of Reference for Languages by the Council of Europe, the European Framework for the Digital Competence of Educators, and the Cambridge English Digital Framework for Language Teachers. And there is a big variety. As you see, we have explored many, and we really were inspired by these. So as you see here, the three levels that we propose, the three levels of proficiency progression for language teachers' digital competences profile, were novice, proficient, and expert, and were inspired also by Bloom's taxonomy, which explains the subsequent cognitive stages of any learning progress, from remembering to understanding to applying and analyzing, and finally to evaluating and creating. So the main aims of this framework were, first, identify the key components needed in order to carefully design an assessment framework that could address the digital skills needed to be acquired for language teachers. And to that end, the framework provides a new set of skills parameters of three levels of difficulty. So as I said before, novice, proficient, and expert. And that described from the most basic to the most advanced, the knowledge and skills that a language teacher should need to acquire in order to be able to cope with his or her professional digital challenges. Knowledge refers mostly to the understanding of theory, while skills are seen as the abilities to put the knowledge in practice. In fact, the digital assessment framework proposes a holistic skill set perspective, which includes a variety of skills which are related not only to the efficient use of digital tools and their integration in the teaching process, but also to the right use of tools and methods. Let's see here, methods for assessment, digital content. I will show you now this one. And here it is, the framework. As you see here, we have six different categories. Those are the technology, pedagogy, assessment, content, professional development, and learner support. And each category includes a set of five concrete subcategories. And as you see here, in the first category, that is called technology, is included the description of knowledge and skills related to the efficient use of technology in the context of language education, so with this in mind. The second category refers to pedagogy and presents the pedagogical perspective of the use of technology. So being a digital competent as a language teacher doesn't mean that I only know how to use technology, but I need to know how to implement technology based on and in line with the pedagogues, as we said before, as our keynote speaker said before, we also need to know how to work digitally, to how to do the assessment digital online, how we create open educational resources, digital material, how we can grow our professional development, what skills do we need, where to search for training, for example, and how, of course, to support our learners. So it's not only us, but we need to pass the knowledge also to our learners. All these subsections, and for technology, for example, we say that you need to specifically to know, but to also to be able work with specific digital tools and devices. And of course, all this, as I said before, we have three different levels of competencies, but we need to know about ethics, security issues in social media and collaboration platforms. We need to know about a collaborative language learning supported by technology, as Professor Burston discussed about collaboration. We need to be able to do our work also, to learn how the different modes of digital feedback that are really, there is a huge variety. So we need to be able to create, as I said before, our open educational resources, our digital material, but to know, to be aware of the copyrights. So all these are all the the main categories and subcategories. And as I said, there are different based on the level, there are different prerequisites, and the knowledge is different for every level. So the skills also are different. When we go to the, as example, to the basic, to the novice, we need to learn and to be able to use everything, let's say, in the, let's say, novice level. And then we have the tool, and I am concluding. The tool has different, as you see here, we have the same categories. And for each of these, it is a self-assessment rubric. There is a set of questions for each of these different components. And in the end, you can have, let's say, a score that it is automatically generated. And I'm finishing, I'm concluding, I know the time has passed. So it's important to keep in mind that acquiring digital competence, it is not so simple, but it is a multifaceted dynamic goal for language teachers to pursue in their professional development. This framework that we have developed aims at providing and supporting language teachers, providing a self-reflection tool, first of all. So you saw these different categories, so you can self-reflect on all these. Do I have all this knowledge and skills? How do you feel? And then try to test it. And I think that it would be also a nice base for discussion and self-reflection. Thank you so much for your attention. And I am passing the word to my colleague, Maria Victoria Soule from the Cyprus University of Technology, who is going to discuss about the last phase, the training model and guide and the sessions that we did.